Take a look at this figure. Do you remember seeing similar images anywhere? You may have seen such figures on television, in magazines, or newspapers. Do you know what information is conveyed by this figure? Well, this figure is called a pie chart. A pie chart is actually a circle graph. The following session will help you learn about pie charts. There are men, women, boys, and girls traveling in this train right now. This is the pie chart of the people traveling in this train. It contains four sections, each representing a particular group of people. The size of each section represents the proportion of a group of people in relation to the whole. The whole circle of this pie chart represents all the people in the train. Let us take the men section of this pie chart. We can see that the section for men is exactly half of the whole circle. This tells us that half of the people in the train are men. We can also see that the parts of the circle representing women, boys, and girls make the remaining half of the circle, which means that women, boys, and girls make the remaining half of the people in the train. There are many other details that we can easily infer from this pie chart. Do you notice that the section for women makes a quarter of the circle? From this, we can say that women make a quarter of the people in the train. We can also conclude that there are more men in the train than women, boys, or girls, and that there are fewer boys in the train than men, women, or girls. These facts are obvious from the sizes of the sections representing the different categories. If we know that there are 1,000 people in the train altogether, it is possible for us to immediately tell that there are 500 men in the train. Can you guess how? With the help of the pie chart, we already know that half of the people in the train are men. We also know that the total number of people in the train is 1,000. All we have to do is to find out how much half of 1,000 is. Half of 1,000 is 500. Therefore, the number of men in the train is 500. Now that we have found the number of men, let us move on to find the number of women. How many women are there in the train? Look at the women section of the pie chart. The size of that section is a quarter of the whole circle. If a section in a pie chart is right angled at the center, the size of that section is a quarter of the whole circle. Since the women section of the pie chart is right angled at the center of the circle, we can say that a quarter of the people in the train are women. We know the total number of people in the train is 1,000. We also know that the section which represents women is one quarter of the whole circle. All we have to do is to find how much one quarter of 1,000 is. One quarter of 1,000 is 250. Therefore, there are 250 women in the train. Let us now find how many girls there are in the train. Unlike the other sections in the pie chart, we have been given a percentage that represents the girls. The 20% simply means that 20% of people in the train are girls. This makes our task much easier. We have to find out how much 20% of 1,000 is. 20% of 1,000 is 200. Therefore, there are 200 girls in the train right now. Let us now find the number of boys in the train. In order to find the number of boys, we may first find the percentage of boys in the train. It is not possible to directly state the percentage of boys from the pie chart, but do you notice that boys and girls make a quarter of the circle? We know that 20% of the total people in the train are girls. All we have to do is subtract the percentage of girls from a quarter. Always remember that a quarter is 1 over 4, or 25%, and that half is 1 over 2, or 50%. We know that a quarter is 25%. When we subtract 20% from this 25%, we get 5%. Therefore, the percentage of boys in the train is 5%. Now that we have found out the percentage of boys, we can easily find out the number of boys in the train. How much is 5% of 1,000? 50. Therefore, there are 50 boys in the train. Note that the number of boys can also be found by subtracting the number of men, women, and girls from the total number of people in the train.